to get it for you, that's fine, but I can't bring it to you.
Yeah, that's a great idea. Maybe you should. Yeah, we'll dip the Nerf noodles in reindeer piss and wait for you to fly over the house. How's that sound, Commie Claus?
What else would you like? Lots of other toys. There's Legos, there's bicycles, there's cars and trucks.
Yeah, like I didn't know there were other toys.
What do you think?
What do I think? I think I should make you eat my shoe.
It's okay, we're dead.
Jesus Christ. You happy now, Santa? See what you did?
Aww.
Yeah, aww. Guy pretends he has a soul now. Listen to that phony delivery. Apparently the mall fired his ass and sent the new Santa to the kid's house to make up for it.
There was a mistake made yesterday, huh?
Yeah. Kid's like, yeah, you did. You made a mistake. Get to the point, what are you doing here?
Well, we're so sorry about that, okay?
I don't know, it depends. You gonna tell me I can't have my shoes now because someone up the road beats their wife with them?
Well, that put me in the holiday spirits, and I'm not the only one, as of course right now hashtag vote them all out is trending as people are more increasingly searching the term tar and feather on Google, as of course just moments ago a gang of masked bandits literally stole trillions of dollars from our grandchildren. So yeah, that's happening. Welcome back, beautiful and amazing human beings. This is Okadowski of WeAreChange.org. And of course, the intro video was from Joey B. Toons. It was only a short excerpt of his longer video that just came out. The link to his channel will be down below. But as Joey says it more eloquently, if you exploit Santa to promote your bastardized political viewpoint, you're an a-hole. And of course, there's a lot of a-holes around, especially in government, like Governor Gretchen Whitmer of Michigan that exploited Santa, that told children to obey her crazy decisions. And of course, not to be outdone, Dr. Fauci just came out and said that he personally jabbed Santa Claus with an experimental rushed medicine that has a long list of side effects. Like, why? Why would you do that? Why would you scare children? Again, seriously, this guy, even though he looks like a little Keebler elf, seriously needs to stop acting like the Grinch. He also, by the way, just moments ago publicly took this jab himself, along with, of course, other politicians like Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez, who is now being accused of being a line jumper, since according to the official story, there are many other vulnerable elderly people at risk that should have got it first. Either way, I definitely agree with Tulsi Gabbard here on this particular issue, with her blasting the CDC as heartless bureaucrats, and that she, of course, won't be taking the jab until seniors get it themselves. Also, Dr. Fauci's counterpart, Dr. Bricks, by the way, is going to be, quote, retiring after showing that she is an utter hypocrite, telling and demanding everyone to stay home, as of course she gavelants around, goes out of state to have a huge Thanksgiving holiday weekend with three generations of her family. And again, one point here, when you're consuming the news, we always have to understand when it comes to politicians that these are absolutely ruthless opportunists that are little gremlin-like creatures that don't care about any living soul and will abuse and destroy anything loving and holy. So when you're consuming the news, just remember that very important backdrop. And of course, I am here to provide you this important context as independent media and not the mainstream media that literally brown noses all these plutocrats. And one way I could do that is by having merchandise, which if you buy, supports me. And usually what I wear is usually what I sell, like this very nice hat here behind me that says Meek Taxation Theft Again. Or look, we also coincidentally have I Survived My 2020 Year, and all I got was masks, riots, a lockdown, more surveillance, the Great Reset, and the shirt, which you could only exclusively get on our Teespring store, which we have a boatload of different shirts available to you, along with masks, hats, bikinis, socks, you name it. If it's ridiculous and facetious, we got it. Very proud of the dry humor and satire that we have personally exploited to the fullest extent. And again, your purchases do keep us up and running. So yeah, check out all the different merchandise we have on teesprings.com/stores/WeAreChange. The link to that will be down in the description below. Click it right now because you have a lot a lot of different products to go through and check out. Seriously, you just got to keep scrolling and keep going down because, I mean, we have a lot of different stuff. So yeah, check it all out by clicking the link down below right now. So before we get into the main topic today about this, of course, stimulus, which is anything but stimulating, it's more like grand larceny theft, I wanted to point out in the backdrop that all of this is happening with, of course, record US dollar printing, where in 2020 already we have printed more than 35% of all US dollars in existence. Yes, 35% of all US dollars have been printed in just within the last 10 months. And now, of course, more will be printed as the House and Senate just voted and approved a $2.3 trillion spending and relief package that will go on the U.S. President Donald Trump's desk very soon. All of this as the United States is already $27 trillion in national debt. And when you look at those numbers, they are not favorable to any positive economic outlook or forecast from here because those numbers are absolutely crazy. I'm sorry, you can't print 35% of all dollars ever created in existence and still want trillions of dollars for these insane bills and think everything is going to be okay. It is not. The only dissenting voices have been a few senators like Mike Lee, Rand Paul, Ted Cruz, Ron Johnson, Rick Scott, and Marsha Blackburn, and a few other U.S. representatives like Tulsi Gabbard that have actually voted against this. But this monstrosity is not just a warning sign toward economic doom and collapse. It is also just another ridiculous slap in the face for any rational thinking human being. What this essentially is proof that the entire insane situation in 2020 is being exploited by world governments to steal whatever wealth is left. And that's exactly what is happening right now, especially when you look at some of these larger provisions of a bill that, by the way, no one has read. This bill, this stimulus package, all of these things coming together in this Frankenstein morphed spending bill that now is two bills come together as one. Again, they make it confusing so you don't understand what's going on here. It's one massive spending bill that the House and Senate voted on. This will go to the desk of U.S. President Donald Trump, and hopefully he will veto it, or if he doesn't, he's just going to prove how he is more of an establishment crony puppet and an individual who, of course, doesn't represent the people of the United States. Let's just be honest here, and let's put it bluntly here, because that's exactly what the passage of this bill would mean. A bill, by the way, that, again, most representatives don't even know what's in it, as, of course, U.S. Senator Mike Lee even described how this bill is taking hours to print, and no one in Congress has even read it. Yes, the U.S. Senate, the U.S. Congress members voted on a bill that they didn't even read. Even Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez brought up an important point that even her political counterparts like Charlie Kirk agree on, saying, quote, "This is why Congress needs time to actually read the package before voting on it. Members of Congress have not read this bill. It's over 5,000 pages, arrived at 2 p.m. today, and we are told to expect to vote on it in 2 hours. This isn't governance, it's hostage taking." But for some absolutely unexplainable reason, Well, it is Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez. She voted yes. She voted in favor of this bill that she didn't read herself. Again, keep that backdrop of who politicians actually are and how scummy they are, and then everything will absolutely make more sense to you. This is what we prefaced in the beginning of this video. Now, what's in this bill? People are finding out, and they're absolutely shocked that Congress is literally giving themselves a handy in this bill by awarding themselves $89 million towards furniture in the Senate office building, doubling the healthcare budget for themselves, since, of course, they get socialized free healthcare, and they probably rewarded themselves with a lot more that we don't even know about. And again, it's absolutely, utterly insane what is happening right now, since even many Republicans are turning to the worst forms of socialism that is absolutely decrepit and self-serving, as correctly called out by individuals like Rand Paul, that called fellow Republicans who voted for this, quote, no better than socialist thems, and he is absolutely right. When we take a deeper dive into what is in the bill, there's also sneaky legislation that will turn you into a felon if you, quote, illegally stream more insane pirating laws protecting the demonic entities from Hollywood, of course. Inside of the bill, the word missile appears 19 times, aircraft appears 208 times, munitions 46 times, weapons 46 times, healthcare 24, doctors, nurses 5, as of course this bill also provides more pork for the military-industrial complex, $4 billion for Navy weapons, $2 billion for Air Force weapons, $500 million for Israel, which of course also was caught selling off a lot of U.S. military secrets to China, by the way, recently. But I guess we're going to reward them with $500 million. There's also $6.9 billion for the United States Antarctica program, whatever that means. Of course, a lot of conspiracy theorists' eyes have been opened and ears perked to this latest news. And it's not just Israel getting their socialistic welfare. It's also Egypt that for some reason is getting $1.3 billion. Sudan that is getting $700 million. Ukraine, Nepal, Burma, Cambodia, Pakistan, all of them are getting hundreds of billions of dollars for what? And I'm sorry, but when you have a country that's literally in debt, they should not be allowed to give out money willy-nilly to other countries. And this meme put out by Ted Cruz definitely speaks to what a lot of Americans are going through right now, as they are obviously shocked since, of course, the U.S. government closed down many businesses, locked down cities and states, prevented people from earning a livable income. They drove people into poverty, made them lose their jobs, face eviction, and all they're going to get for it is just $600. Meanwhile, $10 million is literally going to Pakistan for gender studies. Yes, $10 million. This is the big caveat here that a lot of the mainstream media folks and some people online are missing here, especially brain dead people like Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez, is that this is actual money that of course we are going to be taxed for and will be given the bill for later in one way or another. To say that this is a slap in the face is definitely putting it lightly, as described by Tulsi Gabbard recently, one of the few people who actually voted against this monstrosity. Donald Trump, whose idea it was to give the $600, who's bragging about this idea, by the way, let's just be honest here, most likely will capitulate and sign this bill, and forever establishing himself as the biggest swamp goblin of them all when he codifies this into law. And when he does that, oh boy, do we have some serious ramifications coming our way because of this. It's absolutely ridiculous, whether it's the value of the US dollar, inflation, future taxes, future penalties. The government will have to attune to all of this insane, reckless spending, and you will be footed this bill and no one else. The ones responsible, they're getting new furniture. They're getting free healthcare. They're selling you out down the river, including the ones that you think are on your side, like Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez, that voted for this bill, and of course, U.S. President Donald Trump, that most likely will sign it into law very soon. I might be wrong. I hope I am wrong. I would be pleasantly surprised if Donald Trump doesn't sign this. I hope he doesn't. But when he does, there's no excuses. This is the game that I've been warning about ever since Donald Trump took his seat in that presidential office, this larger divide and conquer agenda that's being played against you. Meanwhile, both sides know the game is rigged and they're benefiting off of your misery. That's what I think. If you think I was wrong in any way, shape, or form, let me know why down in the comment section below. I always appreciate the constructive criticism. I always appreciate the dialogue. If you found this video helpful, please, my golly goodness gracious, family-friendly show here, Share this video with your friends, family members, strangers walking down the street. I don't care. Person you bumped into the supermarket. Hey, you should watch this latest video on youtube.com/wearechange to give you a highlight of exactly what's going on here so you're not a sleepless little zombie that's a little corporate slave that wants to be used and abused by the establishment that doesn't give a damn about him. Use those exact words, by the way, especially in the supermarket situation. It should be interesting, but do it with a smile on your face. And then please let me know what happened. I wouldn't be here if it wasn't for you, and this is why. I love you guys. Stay tuned for more here on wearechange.org.